Hello everyone, in this session we will look into the concept of current chopping in circuit breakers and interruption of capacitive current when the circuit breaker contacts are opened. Before looking into what is meant by current chopping, you know that we have learned from the arc interruption theory of circuit breakers that the arc will be quenched whenever the current crosses its natural zero point. That is only in the case of AC circuit breakers or when we use AC supply. So what is this current chopping? Current chopping is a phenomenon wherein you are forcibly quenching the arc or you are interrupting the arc current before it reaches its natural zero. So if you observe, this is the natural zero point, right? But before the current reaches the natural zero, several times the arc current is quenched. That means several times the arc current becomes zero and again the arc will restrike and again becomes zero. So look here, this is the arc current. It gets quenched here at this point. And after a small interval of time, again the arc current is there. That means the arc is formed. Again for a short period it is quenched and again an arc is formed. And again after a short duration the arc is formed. So the markings which I have done in red, that is the interval for which the arc doesn't exist, okay? And whichever I mark in green, this is the duration where your arc has restriked. Okay, this green one indicates the arc has restriked. So all the red markings is where a small interval wherein the arc has quenched. That means the arc current is zero. So whenever the arc current is zero, you can observe that there is the increase in the voltage. It's in the negative side. Okay, that is nothing but the prospective values of the voltage. So before the current reaches its natural zero point here, this is natural zero point, several times the arc current is interrupted. This phenomenon is called as current chopping. So where is this phenomenon going to occur? Whenever you are interrupting a small value of the current, that means usually you see when a circuit breaker is used to break the circuit of unloaded transformer or the shunt reactor, in that case the current chopping will occur because the unloaded transformer or the shunt reactor, it carries only the magnetizing current, which is very very less compared to your full load current or the fault current. Okay, so even that will be treated as a fault, and that to interrupt, it will interrupt well before it reaches the natural zero point. So this current chopping phenomenon is mainly observed in a vacuum circuit breaker. Okay, vacuum circuit breaker and air blast circuit breaker. So current chopping is usually observed in vacuum circuit breaker and air blast circuit breaker. But in the case of oil circuit breaker, you don't have this current chopping phenomenon. So let us see what actually this current chopping phenomenon is. So whatever red markings are there in this current waveform, I have told you that it is the interval for which the arc has restriked again. So whenever the arc is restriked, you can see the corresponding voltages, okay, corresponding voltage is this one. It's high, and you can even see that there is a sharp fall whenever the arc is interrupted. The voltage is high, so you can see, and finally the voltage across the circuit breaker contacts is nothing but the recovery voltage. So here, since the magnetizing current of the shunt reactor is very very less, the arc will be quenched well before it reaches the natural zero point. So now let us consider an example of a shunt reactor, okay, along with the circuit breaker, so that you can understand this concept clearly. So we'll consider a shunt reactor. Okay, we have R, we have the inductance L, we have the capacitance C, and we have the circuit breaker. Okay, so this is your circuit breaker. The current flows through the inductor, capacitor, and resistor. So in this particular circuit, L is nothing but the inductance of the shunt reactor, and C is the capacitance of the winding, and R is for the eddy current loss. R represents the resistance for the eddy current loss in the reactor. So let us now consider that the magnetizing current is flowing, which is of a very low magnitude. Okay, the magnetizing current flowing is of a very low magnitude. So under normal condition, the current flowing through the reactor will be I. Okay, the current which is flowing through the reactor will be I, and the magnetic energy which is stored will be half. Magnetic energy stored in the reactor will be half Li square. Okay, but once you open the circuit breaker, what will happen? The current chopping will take place, and the current through the reactor becomes zero. So I repeat, once you open the circuit breaker contacts, the current chopping phenomenon, that means the once circuit breaker is contact is open, means the arc is formed. Since the arc is formed, this whatever medium is present in the circuit breaker, it will quench the arc well before its natural zero. So current chopping will take place, and the current through the reactor becomes zero. So when there is a sudden drop of current, then what will happen? A high voltage will be developed across the inductor. So when the current becomes zero, obviously you will have a very high voltage across the inductor. So if the voltage across the inductor increases, what will happen to the voltage across the capacitor? That will also increase. That means VL increasing is nothing but VC also increasing. So whatever stored energy was there in the reactor, okay, is now transferred to the capacitor. That means our energy, which was in the form of electromagnetic charges, now gets transferred to capacitance in the form of electrostatic charges. So that means what is the energy stored in the capacitor? It is half CV square. So half CV square. So the energy which was in the form of my electromagnetic charges now gets converted to electrostatic charges. So V is nothing but the voltage across the capacitor. So if you equate this, half and half get cancels. So how can you write V? V is equal to I into root L by C. Okay, V is equal to I into root L by C, where this V is nothing but the prospective voltage across the capacitor when the current is getting chopped. So usually the prospective voltage will be greater than the natural voltage of the system. So what will happen? if this prospective voltage is high compared to the supply voltage, then the arc will restrike again. So this process repeats. So arc will restrike, again gets quenched, again restrikes, again get quenched until the current has reached the natural current, natural zero point. At that time, the arc is completely quenched and the voltage across the circuit breaker will be the recovery voltage. So next, let us see. Actually, if the arc shouldn't restrike, no, the withstanding capacity of the gap should be very much high. That means your dielectric strength of the gap should be very high. Next is how capacitive current gets interrupted when the circuit breaker contacts are opened. So when we have an unloaded long transmission line or when we have a capacitor bank and you have a circuit breaker in association with it, and when the circuit breaker gets contacts get opened, the unloaded long transmission line or the capacitor bank will be carrying current that gets interrupted. Okay, so if this capacitive current gets interrupted, then you know that a very high voltage transients will be developed across the gap of the circuit breaker or nothing but the circuit breaker contacts. So you see, this is a simple circuit of a power system wherein you have the capacitor C, which represents the stray capacitance of the circuit breaker. CL, it represents the line capacitance. And the stray capacitance value C is very much less compared to CL. That means our value of CL is greater than C. It is very much greater than C. So now let us look. If initially your circuit breaker contacts are closed, okay? If circuit breaker contacts are closed, what will happen? The current which is flowing through the supply will charge this capacitor CL to the maximum voltage, is it not? It will charge to its maximum voltage. Now, if you open the circuit breaker contacts, then what will happen? If circuit breaker contacts are opened, there is no current flowing through the capacitor CL and this particular maximum voltage will be retained by the line capacitance. Now, what is the voltage across the circuit breaker contacts? This is your circuit breaker. So, what is the voltage VR across the circuit breaker contacts? How to find it? It is, this is plus minus. So, it becomes VC minus VR minus VCL equal to 0, or VR is equal to VC minus VCL. So your voltage across the circuit breaker contacts or the gap of the circuit breaker is nothing but the stray capacitance voltage minus the line capacitance voltage. So what is going to happen? So you see here, in this diagram, you have this particular line is the current. Okay, this red one, whatever I mark is current, and the blue one, whatever I mark is voltage. You can observe that when the current reaches zero, that is at point A, you can observe the voltage is maximum at M. So the current is zero at point A, and the voltage is maximum at M. That is when the circuit breaker contacts are opened. Okay, so whether the load line capacitance gets charged? No, it will retain its charge. So you have the voltage across the stray capacitance. This is the circuit breaker contacts. You have the voltage across the line capacitance. Now what will happen? There is a path for the current to flow back to the supply. Okay, so what will happen is the voltage across the circuit breaker contacts gets doubled. This tries to discharge, but this and this gets added up. So the voltage across the circuit breaker contacts becomes twice the capacitor voltage. Okay, and again when the current reaches zero, the current waveform crosses and it becomes zero at this point. So at this point, when the current becomes zero, the voltage will drop from 2VC to zero. And again, when the current is increasing, the voltage across the line capacitance gets added to VC. So 2VC, again VC gets added up. Again, after the current zero, again you see here at the maximum you can find the voltages three maximum. You can find this is 3 maximum, 2VC plus VC. Again VC, this charge gets added up. Okay, so this goes on repeating. 2VC plus VC becomes 3VC, again plus VC it becomes 4VC. So 4VC plus VC becomes 5VC. So you can observe here, this is a 5V maximum. So this process repeats. Okay, but practically this capacitive current is not allowed to increase more. So here it is shown 5 maximum, the voltage is shown 5 maximum, again it becomes 6 maximum, 7 maximum, but usually the peak value of the system voltage is usually limited to 4V maximum, beyond which it is not allowed. If it is allowed, then you will have very high transient voltage occurring across the circuit breaker context. So we have to design, or we have to select the circuit breaker in such a way that it will interrupt the large capacitive current without causing any damage to the system. So the next video we will see the concept of AC circuit breaking and DC circuit breaking.